वेरी गुड डे टू ऑल ऑफ यू एंड दिस इज़ योर फर्स्ट क्लास एंड आई केम हियर टू टीच यू इंग्लिश. हियर यू हैव बीन एक्सपीरियंसिंग टू बुक्स इन नाइन्थ क्लास एक्सेप्ट ग्रामर. सो एज इन द सेम वे हियर यू टू हैव बीन एक्सपीरियंसिंग टू बुक्स एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू द बुक फर्स्ट फ्लाइट and the first chapter A Letter to God by G. L. Fuentes. As you know, he belongs to Mexico. He is a Mexican novelist, poet. He was a journalist, one who write the reports for the magazine and newspaper. He was born on December 17, 1895 and was died in 10 December 1966. Whatever the experience he has written, that is given in the chapter. But before starting it, I would like to share a little things about myself, as I am Shivaji Tripathi, came here to teach you English. Though I have lots of experience, having seen my age, you can estimate about it. And I feel proud that I was appointed as head examiners for board examinations for ISC and ICSC as well as CBSEs. In CBSE, AISSE and AISCE. Now, ISC and CBSE, there are quite little bit difference, but it is recognized by the government and right now it is very much popular in India. Most of the competitive questions are based on such CBSE patterns, NCERT books. So if I will try to suggest you, to give you the clear-cut explanation of the topic, I think it would be easy and interesting to you to understand. Now, here, let us see. Generally, you would have experienced about, and I can't say that of your little age you would have experienced about the prayer and God. Only you would have been hearing and listening from your grandparents and parents that they are going to worship into the temple. They are adoring the God. They are just sitting before the temple under the tree to have a Satyanarayan Vrata Katha and so on. These are some religious moments. And we experience all these things. But here, unflinching faith. We see that a person has the deepest faith into the God. And it is said that the mountain can be moved if you have the faith. Here the character Lancho, the simplest farmer, peasant, now living in the whole village, a single house located on the top of the low hill, and from there he was able to watch and take care of his fields, of his agricultural plots and rivers and so on, and have firm faith in God. He trusts deeply into the God. So such a faith, if anybody has into the God, no doubt at all, everything can be changed. So as this one thing, here Lencho, the faith of God has been kept by, you can say, the messenger and angel and other means of God's. because of the hail storm, Lenchu's crop was destroyed, ruined. Because of the hail storm, frozen waters, because of the condensation into the sky. जब स्काई में कंडेंसेशन होता है, फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट पे जाता है, तो वहाँ पानी की बूंदें फ्रीज कर जाती हैं, ओलावृष्ट हेलस्टोन, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ इट हिज क्रॉप्स वर रुइंड डिस्ट्रॉयड. अ सीट ऑफ आइस हैज बीन सीन ओवर द फील्ड्स. दैट वाज वेरी पिटिएबल सीन फॉर लेंचो. He was surprised to see such natural disaster. It was very hard to survive the life in the whole year without food. They'll die for hunger. And also he hasn't any more to sow into the field for the next year. उसके पास और भी कुछ पैसे भी नहीं थे कि अगले साल की बुआई के लिए कुछ वो कर सके. Therefore, as he has firm faith in God that God is everywhere, he looks everybody, he looks everywhere. Therefore, in this way, idea came into his mind and he wrote a letter for the address of God. That is, in unrealistic condition, it cannot be. In this real world, can it be? Can we send a letter to the God? No, it is impossible. It cannot be. Only by meditation we can connect our soul with the God. As many more yogacharyas now say about it. बहुत से श्री रामदेव बाबा हैं और भी लोग हैं. कभी कभी स्कूल के प्रेयर में भी होता है मेडिटेशन करो. The students now meditate themselves. But actually what does go into their mind at that meditation, it is impossible to say. क्योंकि मारे डर से, स्कूल के भय से मेडिटेशन कर रहे हैं और पता नहीं क्या जा रहा है. जैसे कभी कभी घर पे लोग कहते हैं कि पढ़ो, लोग पढ़ते नहीं हैं. Now, but he has written a letter to God. And it was very funny matter when the postman just opened the mailbox, the letter box, and found a letter at the address of God. In a very funniest manner, he just hand over to the postmaster. After a little interlocution, postmaster became very serious. Actually, he want to keep the firm faith of Lenchu in God. He does not like to destroy the faith of God. Faith of Lenchu in the God. Therefore, just he has obliged. He has obliged. He has compelled. He has requested to his employee, to his staff, to add some money, to donate some money from their salary. And they have collected all 70 pesos. Though that is the unit of money, currency, pesos. It is a currency. Now they have collected. And next day, Lenchu came to the post office. He asked if there are any letter at my address. Now he has given the money, envelope. Just he tear it, count it, that it is not 100 pesos. Here we see the ironical situation. We see the irony here. That Lenchu remarks about the employee that they are crook, they are dishonest. Why? Because God cannot be fail. He cannot cut the demand. He would have supplied 100 pesos, but द एम्प्लाइज माइट हैव टेकन 30. दो द एम्प्लाई आर द स्टाफ हैव मैनेज्ड द कंट्रीब्यूशन दे हैव डोनेटेड. नाउ वी सी दैट इज द रियल कंडीशन ऑफ द वर्ल्ड दैट वी सी irony somewhere in our daily life. Now it was the very brief summary of the chapter, and right now I would like to go line by line, and as it would be easy for the students of your standard, you are supposed to find out the meaning of the words, because I will just announce it along with the words. Let me see the chapter. What happens? The house, the only one in the entire valley, entire valley, whole valley, entire means whole, in the whole valley, sat on the crest of a low hill. Crest, that is the height of a low hill. The hill was of low height, but on top of the hill there was a house, and from this height, from the height at which the house was constructed, was made, one could see the river and the field of ripe corn dotted with the flowers that always promised a good harvest. Harvest, that is crop. Harvest means crops. Dotted, now marked with. Dotted, that is the mark. Patch of crops you can see up to a high distance. If you go any a time towards the field, agricultural field by means, in the village area, the you can see the patches of fields that the same type of crops have been shown, and it has been seen up to a long distance. So as from that height, if you climb over the fifth story building, at what height you are at this moment, you can see the near about area. So as from that height, it was easy to view, to see a long distance, that the whole area had been packed with good harvest, good crop. Flowers that always promised. Yes, of course, seeing the condition of the crop that has been promising, that has been assuring, certifying, promise, assure, certify that the crop will grow nicely or will give a high yield, high production. Now here, the only thing the earth needed was a downpour, now heavy rain. It required. What was the then requirement? Irrigation was the then requirement. But irrigation can be possible only because of the raindrops. It was the source at that moment when the writer has written. He wants to highlight that the hell downpours, that is the heavy rainfall, is required. At least a shower, if not a heavy rain, at least a light rain. Shower, that is light rain. Heavy rain and light rain. Bhari varshat aur halki varshat. At least kuch halki varshat ki zarurat hai. Throughout the morning, this is the description of a day. Lencho, who knew his fields intimately, intimately, very closely, as he was a peasant, as he was a farmer. Therefore, a farmer has good knowledge about the requirement of the crop, that how much manure, how much seed, how much other things as water is required, when it is required, at what time of the crop is required. They always make a research of it and they find it. So as Lancho also was very closely connected with the knowledge of the fields, of the crops. So he has proposed, he has thought that at least the crop require water or irrigation. Had done nothing else but see the sky towards the northeast. What could he do? He could do nothing. He could do nothing except watching the sky. That anyhow rain should occur. Now we are really going to get some water woman. He has been saying to his wife, at least having seen the climatic condition, weather condition into the sky, he has proposed to his wife that here we are really going to get some water, really we are going to get some water because of the clouds he would have seen into the sky. Shayad usne badal dekha ho aakash mein to usne aisa kaha ki जरूर पानी बरसने वाला है. द वुमेन वुमन हु वॉज प्रिपेयरिंग सपर, सपर दैट इज लंच और डिनर, ओके, रिप्लाइड एंसर्ड, यस गॉड विलिंग, इट इज द विलिंग ऑफ द गॉड, डिजायर ऑफ द गॉड, इट इज द डिजायर ऑफ द गॉड. द ओल्डर बॉय was working in the field. Yes, he has a little family, the older boy working in the field, while the smaller ones were playing near the house. As you, that you would have been reading your course daily, sometimes you would have been going through your course. If there might be any infant child into your house or one or two years, he would have been playing here and there into the corner of the house. It means he is careless, carefree. But you are careful that you have been going through your course. Now, in the same way, the little child have been playing here and there until the woman called to them all. Up to what time the little children play? Until their mother do not call. वो तब तक खेलते हैं जब तक उनकी मम्मी उन्हें बुलाती नहीं है. Now, come for dinner. आओ खाना खाओ. Come for dinner. Now, it was during the meal, that is meal time, that just as Lancho had predicted, guess, estimate, forecast, big drops of rain begin to fall. What does Lancho predict? What does Lancho predict here? There is a question. What does Lancho predict? Now, big drops of rain begin to fall. In the northeast, a huge mountain of clouds could be seen approaching, that is coming. The air was fresh and sweet. The air was fresh and sweet. Actually, the air can be felt fresh. but it cannot be felt sweet because we cannot taste the air. That is only pleasant feeling. The air is cool. The air is not warm. The air is very nice, as the morning breeze, morning air, as little bit cool air in summer season. Now, mountains of clouds means just you see the clouds in a large amount of clouds. Now, approaching, the air was fresh and sweet. The man went out for no other reason than to have the pleasure of feeling the rain on his body. And when he returned, he exclaimed. Just in a very happiness condition, he was very happy, and therefore he went outside in order to feel the rain, to enjoy the rain along with the crops. So, as he has been returning, he exclaimed. Now, in surprised manner, exclamatory sentence, have you heard? Now, he exclaimed in surprise. What? These are not raindrops. Then what? If these are not raindrops, as he was feeling the rain that was falling from the sky, he was experiencing, but as he was returning, he has exclaimed, he announced in a surprising manner that these are not the raindrops. Then what? These are falling from the sky. They are now coins. Yes, of course. Now, why the here speaker says and compares the raindrops with coins? That it was very urgent, it was the need for the crops, and in the lack and absence of the raindrops, his crops will destroy and dry, will give no production at all. But as the rain is falling, there is a probability and a hope for good crop, and because of good crop, he would become prosperous after selling the productions. Then the raindrops are to be compared with coins, that actually after the production, he could feel coins or silver coins. इस रेन ड्रॉप को क्वाइन से यूज किया गया, क्वाइन से इसका कंपेयर किया गया, और इस कंपेरिजन को ये बताया गया है कि जब बारिश हो रही है तो ज़्यादा प्रोडक्शन होगा, और ज़्यादा प्रोडक्शन होगा तो उसको ज़्यादा लाभ होगा, वो वेल्दी होगा, प्रॉस्परस हो जाएगा, धनी हो जाएगा, जिसकी वजह से उसको क्वाइन से कंपेयर किया गया. नाउ द बिग ड्रॉप्स are 10 cent pieces and the little ones are 5. Now, just it is a given comparison too. Choti budhe 5 aur badi budhe 10. Ek baat kiya kaha hai, aisa nahi hai ki 5 aur 10 ke sikke mil rahe hain isko. Now, with a satisfied expression, he regarded the field of ripe corn with its flowers. Yes, he was reminding about the crops, about the flowers, draped in a curtain of rain. That has covered in the curtain of rain. The whole area has been covered with in a curtain. But suddenly a strong wind began to blow, and along with the rain, very large hailstones began to fall. Along with the rain, hailstones began to fall. Not only the rain, but also the hailstones began to fall. This truly did resemble new silver coins. It seems that it is a new silver coin. It was actually looking in the same way. That is the coin of silver, white in color. The boys exposing themselves in the rain, the boys, those were exposing or feeling they are enjoying into the rain, ran out to collect the frozen pearls, the frozen pieces of stone, ice. Just they have started to collect it. "It is really getting bad now," exclaimed the man. "That hailstone is not beneficial for the crop. It is wrong thing. I hope it passes quickly. I hope that the falling of hailstone should stop very quickly, passes very quickly, should finish very quickly." It did not pass quickly, but it did not pass quickly. It did not, it was continue falling for a long time. For an hour, the hail rained on the house, yes, the garden, the hillside, the cornfield, on the whole valley, everywhere. The layer of ice has been noticed. The field was white. Actually, it has been become white, the whole area, as if covered with salt. The layer, just the writer has given and compares and says, given an example of salt, as we see the layer of salt that has got covered over the crop. Now, on the whole valley, the field was white as if covered with salt. Not a leaf remained on the tree. Not a leaf remained on the tree. Now, if this is a flowering season for the crops, the stones are the hail, stones are falling from the sky, falling over the flowers. The flowers as well as the leaves of the tree will be separated from the tree. The tree will be naked, without leaf at all, so as his crops were. The flowers were gone from the plants, separated from the plants. Gone from the plants, separated from the plants. Lanchu's soul was filled with sadness. He became very sad. Lanchu became very sad. When the storm had passed, stopped, he stood in the middle of the field and said to his son, "A plague of locust would have left more than this." He has given a remark. Locust, I think you people, if connected with the news, now in the pandemic of COVID-19, you would have heard that the group of locust has been attacking over the field. Tidde ka dal, tiddo ka dal, Pakistan se Bharat mein aaya, Rajasthan, Himachal Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, ye kuch Madhya Pradesh mein bhi, matlab charo har jagah jyada locust, jyada tidde fasal ko barbaad kar. To wo keh raha hai ki wo bhi लाकस्ट अगर आते हैं, टिड्डे आते हैं, फसल को बर्बाद करते हैं, तो भी कम से कम कुछ हिस्सा छूट जाता है, बट इस बारिश में कुछ भी नहीं छूटा है? इस बारिश में कुछ भी नहीं छूटा, कम से कम लाकस्ट, कम से कम टिड्डे तो कुछ छोड़ देते हैं है? द प्लेग ऑफ लाकस्ट, प्लेग दैट इज पैंडेमिक है, प्लेग दैट इज पैंडेमिक इन विच नंबर ऑफ पीपल डाइज. Such a kind of disease, infectious disease, plague, that is infectious disease, would have left more than this. The hail has left nothing. The hail has left nothing. This year we will have no corn, no crop. That night was a sorrowful one. All our work for nothing. We did no work. There is no one who can help us. We will all go hungry this year. It was his prediction. It was his forecasting. He thinks that these are the situation will come before us. Now here is some oral question for the first part. What did Lancho hope for? Why did Lancho say the raindrops were like new coins? How did the rain change? What happened to Lancho's fields? What were Lancho's feeling when the hell stopped? Now these are the assignment for the further class, and I am going continuously, and I would like to finish. But in the heart of all who lived in the solitary house in the middle of the valley, there was a single hope. Those were living. The house was solitary. Lone house. Solitary house, that is lone house. Single house there was in the whole entire village. In the entire village there was a single house. Solitary. And in the heart of all, each and every member of the family, there was a single hope, no other hope than one single hope, that God will help. Help from God. Why? Because previously said, we will all go hungry this year. There is no one who can help us except God, here in the next part. Don't be so upset. Don't be so disturbed, even though this seems like a total loss. Yes, of course, it seems that they have got the total loss. It means whatever they have sown into the field, the money, the cost they have utilized for the production have lost, and also on the other hand, they are not getting any result, consequence or production from their capital used for the production. That is what they say, no one dies of hunger. Remember, no one dies of hunger. But because of only hope of God, they said that no one will die for hunger. Bhook khane ke bagair koi nahi marega. Why do they say so? Because Lancho has firm faith in God. Now, the sentence should be underlined here. All through the night, this sentence should be noted. All through the night, Lancho thought only of his one hope, the help of God. This line is denoting the firm faith of Lancho to God. That in the whole chapter there is a line that can prove and denote that Lancho has a firm faith in God. Now further you see, whose eyes, as he has been instructed. Now, whenever you attend any religious ceremony, religious functions, now orations, here someone will, you listen the priest's sermon, in that way they create faith into the human beings for the God. So Lancho also had got the information that God see everything, even what is deep in one's conscience. what is deep in one's heart, inner. The God has power to visit internal and external, both the things. What is going in the mind and heart of a man has been visited, has been examined by the God. Now, Lancho was an ox of a man, a hard-working man. Ox of a man, hard-working man, working like an animal in the field, but still he knew how to write. Except hard-working, except being a peasant, except being a farmer, he has caliber, he has a knowledge of writing. So, the following Sunday, next Sunday, at daybreak, at the morning, he began to write a letter which he himself would carry to town to place in the mail, to give, to send later, place in the mail. It was nothing less than a letter to God. What was there? That was a letter to God. And he writes the content of the letter. He writes into the letter, God, if you don't help me, my family and I will go hungry this year. I need 100 pesos, that is the